Calculate the average rate of change between adjacent points for the following function. The first few are done for you. What we need to do is to recall our formula for the average rate of change. In order to find the average rate of change from one point to another point, we need to find the change in y and divide by the change in x. I'm going to indicate the change in y with delta y, and then we need to divide that by the change in x. So on the table, I'm going to add a couple of columns. Okay, first of all, let's add a change in y column. As we move from one point to the adjacent point, what is the change in y? Okay, 1 minus 0 is 1, so the change in y is 1. As we move from 1 to 8, the change is 7. As we move from 8 to 27, the change is 27 minus 8, which is 19. As we move from 27 to 64, the change is 64 minus 27, which is 37. And as we move from 64 to 125, the change is 125 minus 64, which is 61. All right, next, let's calculate the changes in x. As we move from 0 to 1, the change is 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. Next, 2 minus 1 is 1. 3 minus 2 is 1. And we can see that for this particular table, the change in x is always 1. So how do we find the average rate of change? Well, we need to take our change in y and divide by the change in x. In this case, our change in x is 1, so every time that we divide by the change in x, we're just simply going to get our change in y value. That's not always the case, but in this case, delta x is equal to 1. So we have a special case where the average rate of change is exactly the same as our change in y. So that's where we got our 1 from, the 7, and we can see that the next value will be 19, the next value 37, and the next value 61. All right, part A, is the function f of x increasing, decreasing, or constant throughout? Well, we notice that our x values are increasing. What's happening to the f of x values? As x increases, the f of x values are getting larger as well, and so that means that f of x is increasing. The y values are getting larger as the x values get larger. Part B, is the average rate of change increasing, decreasing, or constant throughout? Well, we look at our average rate of change column and we see that we have values 1, 7, 19, 37, 61. These values are getting larger. That indicates that the average rate of change is increasing. So in this case, we can say that the f of x values are increasing. Not only are they increasing, they're increasing at an increasing rate.